Hello everyone, and welcome to a brand new Let's Play series, which is, without further ado, once the fanfare's done, Space Quest! That's right, I'll be Let's Playing this game, and more than likely, all the other sequels to this wonderful game. Space Quest, the Sarian Encounter, was made by Sierra Online, published by Sierra Online, and is the brainchild and pet project of two Sierra programmers named Scott Murphy and Mark Crow. It is a wonderful game, and I will be playing the 1991 VGA remake of the original game, which was released in 1986. Now, the original game, released in 1986, had VGA graphics, and had a text-based input system. So, you would tell the main character, whose name is Roger Wilco, which is short for Roger Will Comply, which was an old CB radio transmission that truckers and whatnot would say to each other. Anyway, you would tell Roger Wilco what to do by being like, talk to person, pick up this, and you would type that in. You might see that in future games, because the VGA graphics with the icon-based didn't originally start until Space Quest 4. But since this was developed the same time Space Quest 4 was, this remake now has this icon-based interface, which I think is superior and a little bit more intuitive and fun to play with. What else can I say about this wonderful game? Oh, yes, the remake has also kind of reimagined. This is a lot more, as you can see by the artwork there, that this is more drawn into a 50s B-movie style compared to the original game, which was more classic science fiction fare. But without further ado, well, I'll read the little introduction to you. Eventually, once this evil mantis-like ship, the Sarian craft, tries to catch up to that poor space vessel. As we join our story, the crew of the Arcadia is returning home to Xenon after a successful mission developing the star generator. Exhilarated by their accomplishments, they are oblivious to the fact that a sinister craft approaches rapidly from behind. Oh. Oh my. Oh no. A somewhat spastic research droid blows by in a tiz. Perhaps you could provide some relaxation therapy instruction to reduce its levels of tension. And here we are, the introductory to Space Quest. You're startled by the sound of an alarm. Breaking through it, the intercom crackles with the frightened voice of a technician shouting that the Arcadia has been boarded by unknown intruders. The transmission ends abruptly in a sound storm of white noise, soon overtaken by the cold din of silence. You hear the overly cheerful voice of the ship's computer say, "Destruct sequence is engaged. 15 minutes till detonation." And they're not kidding. Shit will detonate. So before we get started, let's give this game a little save under LP1. And let's get started. As you can see, we have the icons up here. We can use this interface to interact with the environment. Walking, looking, using, talking. Smelling and tasting are not really used for any quest objectives. They're just there for hilarity. I'll be trying to demonstrate as much of the environment as possible. Unfortunately, in this first area, though, I don't have a lot of leisure, because I only have 15 minutes or so. So I should be able to get through everything a-okay, but I might not be able to stop and smell the Roger Wilco, so to speak. The odor you're producing causes you to regret skipping last month's shower. It's you, Roger Wilco, janitor sub-extraordinaire. The light's flashing. Let's see. That seems to ring a distant bell. Oh yeah, now you remember. It means that all living things now on board the ship could die due to some disastrous situation that currently exists. Whatever the case, some personal hide preservation is in order. Alright, well, let's preserve our hides and move our butts over to the side. And we can also speed Roger up, which is what we're going to do. Because, well, it's much needed. Ah, this is an interesting room. Let's just take a quick look around. This is the operation console of the Data Archive Unit. There is a CRT and a chair. Is this the CRT? This is the Model DX Cartridge Retrieval Unit. Its function is to retrieve and return cartridges from and to the storage unit. It is currently empty. Alright, not much else to see. This is a door. Perhaps it leads elsewhere. And the data cartridges are stored in these secure storage modules. You know what, let's see if we can't give this little robot a little lick. I would be violating his airspace if I were you. Okay, well, let's continue on. There's nothing we can really do here. But, let's keep on going to the side. Well, not much here either. It looks like... Oh, we hear footsteps. That means we have to hastily move, because Sarians are coming. Thankfully, we have avoided them. I believe probably what I'll do shortly is, after every chapter or area, I might upload a video which is, you know, kind of like a doing it wrong or a death highlight, because if there's one thing these, actually, this reminds me. If there's one thing these Sierra games are notorious for doing, it's murdering you in all sorts of creative ways. Yeah. So what do we have here? We have a body. It's all that remains of Jerry, one of the few techno dudes aboard who sometimes tolerated your company. Your low clearance excluded you from visiting him during the performance of his duties in the elegant lower level airlock of the Arcadia. Oh, well, maybe he has something on him. You search Jerry's body and find a keycard. Ah, excellent. And we can look in our inventory, and we have the keycard that fits the electronic lock someplace on the Arcadia. And we have 3 Buckazoids. That's the currency in this universe. Of course, we can use and select these items as per needed, but for right now, we don't. Jerry, are you okay? Funny, no response. Can we talk to ourselves? You talk to yourself, and as usual, learn nothing that you didn't already know. Great. Well, might as well head back. We could go down to the lower level, but I have a hunch. Oh, we hear footsteps again. Good thing, it's time to leave the area. Time to come on back. Oh no! The door opens. A man you recognize as one of the head lab scientists stumbles into the room. He appears to be in some serious need of some abdo-seal abdomen filler. Sorry, I'm just adding in the sound effects. After only a few steps, he hits the floor with a disconcerting thud. Hello? Oh god. Let's see if we can't give him a hand. His lips move. The star generator is in danger! The Arcadia is under attack! You better get off this scow if you value your life, Wilco! Just before his systems cease, all functions short of decay, he looks over towards the shelves full of cartridges and utters, Van Allen belts! With one last gasp, his lifeless form slumps to the floor. Van Allen belts? Oh my. Well, we better give this a little just-in-case save. Alright, Van Allen belts. How strange, but let's use this. He obviously was looking towards here. Now, I'll just pause this right here for a moment. We're going to use this screen. Now, a part, of course, of the manual that came with this game gave you proper codes in which you could advance through the game. It was mostly used to prevent piracy, but also add a little bit of flavor to the game itself. So he told us Van Ellen belts, so I'm going to look up the code for this sucker, and we should find it. So let's use this screen. There we go. There's the screen. Now let's see if I can't do this right. It's one that kind of looks like a T, then another little H, and then another T, and then something that kind of looks like a U. Let's put that in. Sorry, that cartridge was destroyed in a freak fusion accident. Check back with us in a few months. Purchasing should have a new one by then. Oh, alright. Perhaps I made a mistake in reading this. These are all kind of funny looking. THT, and then it's this one. Also kind of looked like a U. There we go. I think that was a happy... There we go. Cartridge found. Now retrieving. Okay. Oh, little robot. Let's take that. Wonderful. We have this cartridge that this guy was talking to us about. That's good. Now, I think it's time to GTFO. Okay, now it's time to get our buns to the turbo lift, or maybe we can should just hide in here again. This is the access device to your favorite area of the ship, the closet. You can press footsteps. Oh crap! Let's get going. Okay, turbo lift. Let's use the turbo lift and head on down. Does anything interesting to say about the turbo lift? It is the elevator from one of the upper levels. Well, what do you know? Alright, what do we got here? Oh no! Dead bodies. That's not good. Let's take a look. Oh no, we hear footsteps. You know what? We don't have time to mess around. Let's hide up to the next level. See if we can't avoid these darn Sarians. Oh good. Failing to notice anyone or anything in the room, the Sarian guards decide to check elsewhere. Way to go, Roger! Thanks, game.